Today, I'm going to show you how to create collagraphs on silk. This is video part one, and here I'm just going to show you how to create a really interesting background for your collagraph silk print. We're going to work on three plates at the same time. I created three different versions, three different colours. The plates look like this. I used screen printing silk and different pastes and gels to achieve these effects. This is a very exciting method because you can create lots of very interesting depth, almost photographic quality. This is not a finished product. What we're going to do in part two is work with more intention and respond to what we've created in part one. Hope you enjoy the video. So in today's video, I'm going to work on three prints. And the reason I'm going to work on three prints, I'm going to go large. This just about fits my press. And the reason why I'm going to work on three prints is because I don't want to get too precious about any of them. It's quite a common technique, lots of artists do it, is so you don't focus too much and you just go with your instincts, with your gut, and I think it helps you be more creative and not so precious. So what I wanted to do is follow some of my sketchbook designs. Now, what I love about these is that I have this very subtle background, which was done in watercolour. And then I build this using thicker paints like inks and gesso and black acrylic. And the reason why it works really well is because you go from very diluted, sort of vague, you know, colours into thicker. So you have that contrast. It works really well. Now, I want to recreate that in my prints. Now, the beauty of recreating this in my prints is that if I have three really good bases, I can make lots and lots of prints and I can really muck about with them. I can paint on top of them, I can collage on top of them. I can just have lots and lots of artwork, hopefully, that are going to be very interesting and different, and there'll be loads of rubbish, but hopefully there'll be a few gems out of them that I can pick out and really be proud of. So now, how do I get this diluted watercolour background effect? Well, that's a good question. The way I'm going to do it is I'm going to weirdly start from dark. So I want to have a dark surface, and the way I'm going to do it is I am going to use a double sticky tape. You can get this on Amazon and or any sort of craft store. It basically sticks on both sides, and I'm going to apply this double sticky tape on all my three. Well, it's just Enviromount, which I normally use for collagraphs. I'm going to stick it to all three. And on top of that, I am going to stick a screen printing mesh. Now, screen printing mesh is wonderful because it will print in black. This one is, I believe, let's see what it says. I will put it in my subtitles, what mesh thickness it is. But I mean, you could glue it on, but the problem of gluing it on is if you use, let's say acrylic media to glue it on, then that will get through and then you won't get your sort of even dark surface. But if you use a double sticky tape, you will have your even dark surface. That's first. And the reason why this is so fun is that I'm going to try to get this watercolory background effect by simply applying acrylic, watered down acrylic gloss media, and I'm going to paint over the mesh with it. and it will give me those soft edges. And then I'm going to paint with paint, acrylic paint on top, which will give me these darker edges. And I can always use my carborundum or micaceous iron oxide acrylic paint to get these really, really dark contrasts. Anyway, I'm gonna make a start and see how it goes. Now, I've got sort of slightly uneven edges, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this aluminium tape, and I'm going to kind of protect these edges. Okay, so first of all, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with gloss medium and a paintbrush. And what happens with gloss medium, it will soak into the silk, and it won't be it won't let the ink be completely wiped off, so it won't be the lightest value, but it will be sort of mid-tone. But this is what I'm looking for. So just going to add kind of random brush marks on all three artworks. Okay.
Okay, so I'm now going to use clear tar gel by Golden, and clear tar gel is great because it is a very, very smooth sort of liquid. It will create a very light tone, but also it has a really wonderful consistency. It's fluid but also a little bit sticky, so you can have some lovely effects with it, and you can create sort of very fine lines using a pointy tube. Here I'm using just a flat spreading tool, just to sort of have an even surface. And I'm actually going over both several plates at the same time, just to sort of so the effect goes over the edge. It's a really good way to do it, so it goes over the edge. By spreading it so thinly, this is going to soak into the silk a little bit, so it's not going to be necessarily very light. It will produce mid-tone. I'm just scoring with a dry point tool here just to get some marks while it's still wet. So while all the media is still wet on my boards, I'm just using some kind of scrapers and shaper tools I've got and creating some patterns. I mean, at this moment, you really can't see very much what you're doing. So there is not much of an intention going on at this point. I'm just sort of playing with different pastes and gels to create an interesting background and some tones and some textures. Okay, so I'm back. All my three plates are dry now. Now, it's been a few days since I have done the last video and put the pastes and gels onto the plates. So I can't remember what I've done, but that makes it even more exciting because I'm going to soon find out what they're going to look like. So I have prepared here, I've got a huge tub of Akua ink. It is quite solid. It's quite common with the big tubs of black, apparently. I've had some of you comment on that. So I've used a bit of it doesn't bother me too much because it means that this tub is going to last for ages. I had to sort of dilute it with blending media to get it to the right consistency, but I think I've got where I want to be with this. And I'm going to ink. This is so exciting. I really can't wait to see what's going to happen. And what I'm going to do, because this is going to be a proof print. I'm going to print it on quite a thin paper, just sort of scrap paper. I'm not too precious of what paper I use here. I just want to see and respond. So I'm going to see how what all the lights and darks are and see where I need to add more lights or perhaps tone it down. So let's start with this one. As you can see, I've got a new desk. It's so clean. So I've got lots of scrap mounting board that I like to use for this. I'm not going to use palette knife because I don't want to scratch into my plate. I want to be gentle and careful with it. It's just for the good, generous, dollop. Now with this one, I remember now, I can see it. When I was sticking down the silk, it created some bumps.
It can happen. In this scenario, it's not much of a disaster. Because it's an abstract work, so actually it could work in my favour. I could end up with something quite cool. So I'm inking up generously because I want the whole plate to be covered.
I'm happy that I've covered all of the plate. I'm just blotting the excess ink off with some newsprint. You don't have to do that. You can just go straight in with the scrim. But I like to get the excess off because then scrim gets really dirty with the ink and I can't use it for very much longer. So here's some excess ink off. And I'm just going to grab a bit of scrim and start polishing the plate with a bit of scrim. What's really lovely at this stage, you can see your design starting to show up the more you polish. And this is when it gets exciting because you're starting to get an idea of what the print will look like.
On the press. I've got my wetted paper. It's a very thin paper as I am not really looking for a print as such, more for proof to see what I need to do to the plate.
So now the press is all set, just running it through the press, and a bit of a problem arose, and we need to discuss this. So basically, for some strange reason, this black that I was talking about, this Akua black that I have diluted with blended medium, just didn't quite behave itself, and I don't really understand why. So I ran a few experiments, and I have diluted the black for a little bit longer, so I let it soak with the blending media for a little bit longer, and I did get a better looking print, but I just couldn't get it just didn't print right. And you can see here on a close-up, on the left is worse than on the right. So the left was when I just blended it for a little bit, and on the right when I left the black with blending media for a little bit longer. As you can see, it's just like these white speckles, like the ink didn't quite hold. Yeah, very, very odd. But you will see that I will print with other colours, and they came out perfect. So yeah, Akua, help. Why did it happen like this? Yeah, it would be really, really good to know. So after feeling a bit frustrated, I decided to try other colours. And I started off with this violet. So yeah, gave up on black and decided to go for other colours. Violet was sort of very... fluid consistency, I didn't have to do anything to it. It inked up really nicely and wiped up really nicely. And I have to say, it printed lovely. You will find out very soon. Just like to add that this is actually a different plate. This is not the same plate as previously. This is my second plate.
Yeah, interesting to see if this one will come out better. I'm excited about the purple. Ooh, yeah. Now, this is what I'm talking about.
Yeah, this is showing, we don't have this weird white speckled effect, and all the tonal transitions are very smooth. The depth is wonderful. Yeah, it totally is to do with ink. I did exactly the same thing as I did inking up and wiping off and printing, exactly the same as with the black, but black just did not work. But anyway, this is look good. I love the purple. Let's try the phthalo green, and I'm pleased to say the phthalo green worked out wonderfully.
Okay, I've got my three plates. What I'm gonna do is I just want to see some gorgeous brush strokes. Now I have got proofs of each plate. I've printed each one of them to have a bit more visibility about more or less where the lights and darks are. So obviously I want to preserve some of the darks. I want to have a focal point. I don't want to deter from it. So But I'm not too scared of just going for it, because at the end of the day, if I decide I have put too much light or have done something wrong, I can always go back in with micaceous iron oxide and do some corrections. So I'm not too worried about it. I am going to start from the middle one. So obviously it's a reverse of the image here. This is in black and my print is in green. I did print in green because I was having a problem with the black. It was not printing right. It was doing something very strange. Like this. And I played around with different dilutions of blending media. I got it to work a little bit better, but it was still not as smooth as it should have been. So I'm going to use red paint. Now, why am I using red paint? There is absolutely no significance of that. I could use any colour. I just want to use acrylic paint because it's going to act as a light tone. The ink is going to wipe off it. I'm using red because I have plenty of it. Probably better using white so I can see better what I'm doing, but I don't have very much white and I don't want to waste it. So I'm going to use red instead. And just as you would expect, if I want more version of the diluted colour, more diluted version of the colour, I will just use water, just like you would with painting. So I can see I've got some lights here. I like this area here. I don't want to lose that. Now, not terribly keen on what's going on here. So perhaps I'm just going to maybe you just get some movement. I'm now sort of responding to what's going on in here, but I'm not being too precious about it. Quite like this part here. Oh, this is quite lovely. Yeah, funky. All right, let's move on to the next. Now let's have a look at the proof. Now, quite like here, what's happening here, this part, the swish is quite cool. This part, a bit boring. Perhaps we could do something here. Now this fella here, I kind of like this part, but not huge fan of this part here. So happy to paint over that. Decided to add some dry medium mica flakes.
So now that I let the plate dry overnight, and I'm just going to use the Payne's Grey, which is a lovely Akua ink, and very close to black. I'm avoiding using my black and sticking with what's safe, just inking up with a little bit of cardboard, a little bit of mounting board that I use normally for inking up, and just using Scrim as always to wipe the ink off. And then I will do my proof. I'd also like to add that I do like to use Newsprint to polish the plate after I've just used Scrim, just to get some more definition, more crispier sort of edges. All right, putting down my damp paper and bit of Newsprint and putting it through the press, and here is the big reveal. I'm just gonna see how the new layer has worked out, and as you can see with the Payne's Grey Aqua ink, it worked really well, no problems at all, beautiful depth, almost photographic quality. I love printing on silk, isn't it gorgeous? And the purple was lovely too, a little bit different, but that's what I love about this. You sort of never really know what you're going to get until you print it. But yeah, purple looked gorgeous. Yeah, really pleased with it. So much depth, almost three-dimensional quality to it. It's gorgeous. And lastly, the green. The green looked pretty good as well, printed fabulously. So in the end, actually, by having a bit of the disaster with the black, I ended up with three gorgeous looking different color prints that I might have not otherwise done. I think I would have probably just printed all three in black and white. So this mishap has pushed me into doing something different, which is what happens with art, which is what's so wonderful about it. So just to show you how interesting these prints on silk are, you see how much how many different tonal values, what exciting depth you can get from very dark tones to mid tones to very light. So all the light bits would be the coal tar gel. The mid-tones will be matte, acrylic matte medium. And the surprisingly light ones are acrylic paint. Acrylic paint is quite glossy. But the brush strokes are gorgeous. And same here, this one has got some beautiful dark tonal values. It came out really well with the violet ink. And the green as well has some really lovely textures. So all in all, great. And I'm looking forward on working these in part two to respond to what's going on in these prints in part one. Excuse me while my son is revving his engine outside. Terrible, isn't it? Anyway,
hopefully you'll join me in part two, because I think it will be really worth it. I'm excited to work further on these prints. Thank you for watching and see you soon.